Father, in these moments, our prayer is that this couple would be united in a way that is amazing and miraculous and honored by Christ. Bless their lives, not just today, but every day, we pray in Christ's name. Amen. So on behalf of Noelle and Matt, I want to welcome you. We've come to celebrate this event where two lives become one in the eyes of God. So Matt, you all right?
I'm good.
Good. Will you take this woman to be your wife? Will you pledge your loyalty to her in all love and honor, in all faith and tenderness, to live with her and cherish her for the rest of your life in marriage? If so, say, I will.
I will.
Well, will you take this man to be your husband? Will you pledge your loyalty to him in all love and honor, in all duty and service, to live with him and cherish him for the rest of your life in marriage? If so, say, I will.
I will.
My dear friends, we're gathered here this afternoon to witness the official moment of marriage between these two. Weddings are family time because two families are being joined, the Farleys and the Beechams. But they're also a religious time. You may not know, but the first miracle that Jesus ever performed was at a wedding where he turned water into wine. He took something so ordinary and he blessed it and it became extraordinary. That's what we're hoping today. Taking two extraordinary people and making them even more. You know, folks, for thousands of years, rings have been given and received to seal important and unbreakable promises. You think about the rings we wear, not just decoration, but they mean something. The pure and precious metal of the ring speaks of the purity and the pricelessness of ideal love. It doesn't tarnish, neither should your relationship with each other. But the ring is also a perfect circle about the covenant that's being made today. It's complete. This ring I give you. As a token and a pledge.
As a token and a pledge.
Of these promises.
These promises.
I make to you today. I will love and cherish you forever. May this ring be a constant reminder.
Of our never-ending love.
This ring I give you.
As a token and a pledge.
Of these promises.
I make to you today.
I will love. And cherish you forever.
May this ring.
Be a constant reminder. Of our never-ending love.
Noelle, words cannot begin to describe or do it justice with what I want to say, but I will try. From the first time I saw you walk in at our super classy first date at the hotel bar, I knew that you were the love of my life. Your smile lights up any room you walk into. If anyone asked me what the perfect wife, best friend, and life partner would be, it still would not come close to who you are as a human being. I promise to give you all the love and respect you deserve every single day forever. No matter what obstacles or challenges we face together, I will always be there to support you and have your back. Bringing our families together and creating our own hectic wolf path will be the most incredible experience of my life. And I quite literally could not imagine doing it with any more amazing human being. I promise that I will be nothing but loyal and caring to you and the family we build. You deserve more than you know, and I will always try to give you what you need. I love you more than anything in the world and cannot wait for you to be Mrs. Farley. Now let's do this, have some fun, and celebrate what will be an epic life together. I love you, Matthew. P.S. Please don't spin me a lot on the dance floor.
Matt/Dimples, to the love of my life on our wedding day, holy moly, we're getting married. It's been a hell of a year and I know we've come through the storm together. There's no one I'd rather go through the ups and downs with, grow old with, and most importantly, live with my entire heart the rest of my life. I love you, Matt, and I will hold your hand through the tough times and the happy times. I hope you know how proud of a man you have become and how far you have come, and your light is shining through to change this world for the better in my life. Even the day I met you, you had something special and out of date to excuse myself to the restroom and sat in a feeling of one day about you. I've been waiting for you my entire life and I can't wait to take this journey with you. You're my best friend, my love, my soul. You make this life of mine more colorful and filled with love. I can already imagine our future from our travels, building a life, laughing, and one day becoming parents together. You will be an amazing dad. As I was writing this, I started crying because I had a state of emotion of how far we've come and how much we have overcome already to build a strong life together. I love you, Matt. I'll always love you for all my days. Now let's do this damn thing. Love me.
Father, thank you for these moments. As I celebrate with Matt and Noelle, we celebrate the goodness of God. We celebrate family. We celebrate love, friendships, values. We celebrate lives coming together and being one. My prayer for this young couple is that every day their hearts be turned toward each other. The center of their lives will be love and faith. Bless them today, I pray, in Christ's name. Amen. Noel and Matt, because you've come here today and you promised yourselves to each other in front of God and these witnesses by the authority vested in me, and as your pastor, it is my privilege to declare you are husband and wife. Matt, you may kiss your bride. It's my privilege to introduce you, Mr. and Mrs. Matt McCarty.
We've been here before, walked right through the door. We've been looking for a place to call our home.
I love this town, but I need to breathe.